Hello everyone, in this lecture video I'll be talking about gelatinase hydrolysis test. Here I'll be covering the principle of this test, then how we need to perform this test, that is in detailed procedure, and what are the types by which we can perform this gelatinase hydrolysis test, how to interpret the results, and what are the uses of the gelatinase hydrolysis test. Let's see. Gelatin hydrolysis test. It is a biochemical test which is performed as a presumptive test for identification of Staphylococcus, Enterococcus and other gram-positive bacilli. Gelatin hydrolysis test is also known as gelatin liquefaction test. Why do we call it as a gelatin liquefaction test? Because it involves the liquefaction of gelatin, and that liquefaction of gelatin, it takes place because of presence of gelatinase enzyme. I mean, this gelatinase enzyme is responsible for the liquefaction of gelatin. Now, what is the role of this gelatinase enzyme in the organism which involves in the production of this enzyme? I mean, the role of gelatinase in pathogen. Gelatinase, it is important enzyme which we found in different pathogenic organism. And this enzyme is produced extracellularly, and this enzyme, it carry out the hydrolysis of gelatin, which is derived from the collagen found in the connective tissues of vertebrates. And these enzymes might work as a virulence factor which dissolves the connective tissues of the host cell, and thus ultimately it helps in the to create the what we say is infection, or in it helps in the invasive infection. It acts as a pathogenicity factor. Somehow it helps that pathogens to complete its pathogenesis. What is gelatin? Gelatin is a protein that liquefies in presence of gelatinase enzyme. As the enzyme breaks down the complex structure of gelatin into monomeric amino acid. As I said, that gelatin is protein, and protein is nothing but the polymer of amino acids. So whenever gelatinase act on gelatin, it breaks down into the monomeric amino acid. The test has been used for years as a presumptive test for identification of variety of organisms like Serratia, Pseudomonas, Flavobacterium and Clostridium. Objectives of gelatin hydrolysis test. This test is mainly carried out to test an organism's ability to liquefy the gelatin by production of gelatinase enzyme. Means here we want to find out whether the given organism has ability to produce gelatinase enzyme or not. It also helps us to differentiate the organism into different groups based on their ability to hydrolyze gelatin. Now let's see the principle of the gelatin hydrolysis test. As I told you, gelatin is a protein which is derived from animal connective tissues, that is collagen, which form a solid structure at lower temperature. The protein is degraded by a group of enzyme. We call it as a gelatinase. It means that this gelatinase enzyme, it is responsible for degradation of gelatin. Okay, gelatinases are proteolytic enzyme that hydrolyze gelatin into polypeptide and individual amino acid. The degradation of the gelatin, it takes place in two steps. The first step involves degradation of gelatin into polypeptide, and in second step this polypeptides get converted into amino acid. Gelatinase is important in most bacteria as gelatin is a large polymer and this cannot be transported into cell. So thus this enzyme helps for many bacteria to utilize gelatin in the and for utilization of gelatin in it need to break down into its monomer, that is gelatin is broken into amino acids and then this amino acid is taken by the cell. The enzyme does break down the gelatin into smaller units which can be transported into the cell and utilized by the bacteria. Thus, what we can say that gelatinase is produced by organism and this enzyme helps by two ways. It helps for breakdown of gelatin into smaller units and thus the amino acid is taken by the bacteria, and other role is that it helps as a virulence factor, that is to complete the pathogenicity. In the hydrolysis test, media with gelatin is used and its hydrolysis is observed by two ways, either by the liquefaction of media or by flooding with the mercuric chloride. Means we can perform this test by two ways. One is the tube method and the second one is the plate method. In tube method we go for the liquefaction of media, whereas in plate method we make the use of mercuric acid, mercuric chloride. The mercuric chloride added to the medium, it precipitates the gelatin while the area where the gelatin is hydrolyzed appeared clear. You can see this is the test organism which is inoculated in a plate which contains the gelatin. I mean this is the gelatin agar, and this organism has produced gelatinase enzyme, and because of which the gelatin from this area has been degraded, and therefore after addition of mercuric chloride, what happened? This mercuric chloride, it reacts with the gelatin presence in this plate and it forms the opaqueness. Whereas if you find the area around this colony, you will find the clear zone because the gelatin has been hydrolyzed by the gelatinase enzyme. So nothing is there which will react with mercuric chloride to form the opaqueness, and therefore you will find the clear area around the colony because this organism has produced gelatinase enzyme. In contrast, if you look at this organism, this culture, it has not produced gelatinase enzyme and therefore there is absence of any clear zone around the colony. Here the media which we use for this test, that is the nutrient gelatin media which contains the nutrient agar and gelatin. For the demonstration of gelatin hydrolysis, we can use either the mercury chloride or we can go for the tube method where we look for the liquefaction of gelatin. And the reagent, we have two options. We can use mercury chloride for the plate assay. I mean, if we are using the plate method, then we have two options. We can use the mercuric chloride or tannic acid. The results shown by tannic acid are exactly reverse. It is exactly reverse to the result shown by mercuric chloride. As we have seen in previous picture, that clear zone is seen around the colony after addition of mercuric chloride. But if we add tannic acid instead of clear zone, we find the opaque area around the colony, and that we consider as a positive test. Here, in addition to this reagent, we need inoculating needle, and for incubation we need incubator which is adjusted at 37 degrees Celsius, and of course we need pipette also. how to perform it. The very first step is preparation of media, and here if we are using the tube method, then the media should be added in a tube. Where if we are going for the agar plate method, then you pour that medium into the agar plate. Okay, now for a tube method, the gelatin medium in the tube is inoculated with 4 to 5 drops of 24-hour old culture. Then the inoculated tubes are incubated at 37 degrees Celsius for 24 to 48 hours. If the organism is capable to grow at 25 degrees Celsius, then you can adjust the temperature that at 25 degrees Celsius. After first incubation, the tubes are placed at 4 degrees Celsius for another 24 hours. Okay. Next, if we are going for the plate method, then you inoculate at the center of that plate, that the medium plate containing the medium nutrient gelatin agar. Okay, then you incubate those plates at 37 degrees Celsius for 24 to 48 hours. Next, result interpretation. This is the result of tube test. Here, the partial or total liquefaction of gelatin in the test tube. You can see here the partial or total liquefaction of gelatin is seen, and this indicates the positive results. Complete solidification of gelatin at 4 degrees Celsius, that represents the negative results. Even if after incubating those tubes at 4 degrees Celsius, if you find the liquefaction, that is because of the gelatin is produced by the organism. Whereas if you find that still the media, media looks like a solid, then it is interpreted as a negative result. The positive example of culture which shows the positive results, that is the Bacillus subtilis, and the negative result is shown by the Escherichia coli. So we can use this two organism as a control. Plate method. Here a clear zone is seen around the colony after addition of mercuric chloride. This indicates the positive results, whereas no clear zone around the colony even after addition of mercuric chlorides, that represent the negative results. Here this diagram it shows the use of mercuric chloride, but as I mentioned, we do have one more option of tannic acid. That if we add, instead of mercuric chloride, if we add tannic acid as a reagent for detection of gelatin hydrolysis by gelatinase enzyme, then you will find exactly reverse results. That is, instead of clear zone, you will find the opaque zone around the colony that we consider as a positive, and entire plate will show the clear area. Now, what are the uses of this test? This test is used to determine the ability of organism that produce gelatinases. This test is also helpful in identifying and differentiating the species of Escherichia, Proteus, Bacillus, Clostridium, Pseudomonas and Flavipicturium. It helps to differentiate between the pathogenic Staphylococcus aureus, which is gelatinase positive, from the non-pathogenic Staphylococcus epidermis, which is gelatinase negative. This test is also used to differentiate the Escherichia and the Proteus species, which are gelatin positive, from the other member of the Enterobacteriaceae family. Bacillus anthracis, Bacillus cereus and several other member of genus are gelatinase positive, as are Clostridium titani and Clostridium perfringens. So these are the uses of gelatinous test. Thank you. And these are the references. Thank you.